Okay, today's podcast, we have two special guests. I have Maria Fernanda from Primeiro C with Bia. Hi, Bia.
Hi.
Hi, Mama.
Hi, everyone.
Good afternoon.
They are really shy because today we are recording for the first time in English, but they have accepted the challenge of doing this podcast in English. So I'm really proud of you two, first of all.
Thank you
for accepting this.
Thank you for inviting us.
Yes, you're always welcome. I always love to involve students on my projects. Okay, we're going to talk about the first part of the book, okay? And it involves different types of situations and timing on the story. The book starts with the first chapter, which says the Red Room, which is basically trying to talk about the life of Jane Eyre in her early years. Mama, what can you talk about the bedroom?
The Red Room.
Why is it called the Red Room?
Okay, so we have to start with the beginning because the Red Room has a totally backwards story about the way that Jane Eyre was raised. So, we all know that Jane's parents died and that she was raised by her Aunt Reed and by her husband, Mrs. Reed. And then that room, her beloved uncle died. They always told histories to her about he being haunted by the spirit of...
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it was like a punishment room, isn't it?
Yeah, it's in a punishment room. Every time Jane was in a bad treatment, she acted badly to the ways of her aunt. They put in her that, always telling stories that he was haunted, that if she wasn't a good girl, her uncle would come after her. Mm-hmm. And then Jane has all this emotionally weight in this room. And when her aunt keeps pushing her, she keeps saying that she has an evil inside of her, that she's not a good kid. And her imagination runs really away.
Yeah.
And with this imagination, it wasn't really good to the time. Her aunt keeps pushing her and ends up putting her in Lowood School for young girls.
Yeah.
Thinking that she was a really bad kid, a liar. But in the end, she was just a really scared kid with a really big imagination.
Mm-hmm. We talked about this a little bit on our last podcast. There's some kind of jealousy from her aunt.
Yes.
Because her
uncle loved Jane more than he loved her.
Yeah, you know, she was kind of life. How can he love? Why does he love Jane Eyre more than his
me.
Own kids? So
own
she
kids,
was kind of jealously. About
she
this.
Was really jealous about her.
Yeah, so then after this moment, she lived in with her aunt, and she was really mistreated there. She didn't keep her promise of taking good care of Jane, and then she decided to move Jane to?
Lowood School for young girls.
Let's talk a little bit more about the Lowood School. Lowood
School.
And Jane Eyre's life in there. What can you tell us, Bia, from your perspective?
With 10 years old, she was forced to go to the Lowood School. Ever her going to a place where she posed to a lot of punishments, was diet with tuberculosis and other...
kind of diseases.
Like
It was a really tough place to live, although it was a school, and... the girls there were being well taken care of, but it was not really in good conditions.
Her friend died, old friend.
We're gonna see more about this in the future when she's at Thornfield Hill, and she says, it's been a long time, more than 10 years, that I haven't been close to the fire. So that scene, that's a very cold place. They didn't have good structure there, and probably some of the girls died because of the cold there.
Mm-hmm.
If you have tuberculosis, you need a better place to stay,
and
to relax.
And since it's like almost like a church, all the girls getting sick, they thought it was like the devil trying to get in her body.
Yes.
Because I believe they thought it was like the devil possessing the kids.
They had some kind of. They do have a lot of they do kind of try to make lots of connection with the spiritual thing to the sickness. Okay, so it seems like Lowood, from what you said and from my perspective too by reading the book, it seems like Lowood was a very tough place to live for the girls, especially because girls, the girls that were there, they were not really well accepted on their families, so it was a chance to get rid of them. But still, they also had the opportunity they had to have good education and to learn something. Yeah. So she, let's go step by step. First, we had the Red Room, which is the beginning of her life. Then she went to Lowood School. She stayed there for 10 years. And then she...
8 years, no?
Yeah, I think so. She said 10 years, but she was kind of... I think she was kind of trying to say around 10 years, but I think it was 8 years. That's for sure 8 years.
Yeah.
And then...
They want to make her 16 in the series.
I think she was 18.
18. Yes. 18, and it was 10 years. Yeah. She came with 8 years.
She came in 10.
With 10?
I think she went there with 10, and then she stayed 8 years. That makes sense.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
And then after some time, she was old enough to become like a teacher, professor.
Yeah.
And she started teaching the girls some art, so this kind of stuff, painting or drawing or something like that.
It's the first scene of her being an adult in a movie, in the series. It's the first scene of her painting.
When you see her as an adult, that's true. And then she decides to advertise, which is pretty much, I want to get rid of this place to become a professional in another place. And she was taking her skills of a teacher to move to another place. And this place was...
Thornfield,
where the story really starts making more sense now, because now she's moving to where she's gonna, most of her life will change now, definitely.
The best place of the world,
where she felt like home. That's she says a lot there, yeah. a lot. This
the
kind of
place
thing
that
during the
people
the
really season. Like cared about her. Because in none of the places, other people that cared about her, they died. Like her uncle and then her friend, all of them died. And now she's finally a place full of people that actually care about her. Mm-hmm. Not even a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
For example, Mr. Fairfax.
Mr. Fairfax. She Adele. Likes a lot about Adele. Mr. Rochester.
Mr. Rochester.
Rich Rochester cares a lot about her. He cares a lot about her.
So, now she's in Thornfield. Now she's in Thornfield and she meets this little girl called Adele, which is from... She's a...
Parisian girl.
Parisian. And she starts teaching her different types of lessons.
Yeah.
What is your impression about Thornfield Hill?
So, Thornfield is a completely new place to her, because the only two places she have ever been is her first home with her aunt Reed and her uncle Reed and her cousins, and now the lower school in Thornfield. And Thornfield is basically a mansion if you compare to these days, and she gets that really like, okay, I'm gonna teach here. I waited my whole life to do that, and I'm gonna do it as I was taught.
Mm-hmm.
Thought. And then she tries as much to be the person that they taught her to be, but not losing her internal voice, because she's supposed to be a quiet girl with a little mind just to teach girls, and then stop like this natural woman from 18th century. 19th century. And then, but not losing her like imagination voice, that I believe that the whole imagination that she had, she put it on her paintings.
Mm-hmm.
That's why I believe that she stays there, because it's the only place that she can do whatever she wants, and no one's gonna taught her to do this thing or that thing.
Mm-hmm.
And telling little girls to do that was, I believe she really liked it after all. She used it a thing that was trying to make her get rid of this place to be a good thing to her. Mm-hmm. And teaching Adele was really important to her, because it was really fun. Adele is a really funny girl. And it made her happy, because she really loves Adele and all the people from Thornfield, like Mr. Fairfax, Mr. Rochester. And it has fun and curiosity because there's a mysterious place in Thornfield. It's a really big house with really small place. The first thing she sees when she's got there is that red flag outside the room. And she doesn't realize what's that until a part of the series, of the book and the series. And it's a really happy place because, like you said, and she haven't been next to a fire for almost 8 years. Mm-hmm. She haven't had good food. She had good clothes. She had really bad clothes, if you can say that. And it's a place that she really feels loved. And it's a really good place to her, mm-hmm. even with all the problems that comes after that.
There's one thing that she says, that here's a place where I felt like an equal person.
Yes.
People are treating me like equal. I'm not being treated like someone with no respect. Mm-hmm. People look at me and they respect who I am. So, Thornfield was a place where she felt a good way to live, got a job, but she also met someone that would change her life, which is
Mr. Rochester.
This 40-something-year-old man who took Jane Eyre's heart.
Mm-hmm. For this date, it's like some weird relationship because he's like 40 and she's 18, so
yeah, there was a huge difference of age.
But it was really normal at that time. Yeah. Like people like really, really old men marry really young women.
Yeah, that's true. And the girls were, not in this case, but girls were trying to get involved with wealthy men.
Yeah.
Men with, you know, money, because then he would take care of her. And men were looking for younger girls because they could give him babies. No, you know? So, we have now this element on Mr. Rochester being part of Jane Eyre's life. So, again, what do you think that caught Jane Eyre's attention on Mr. Rochester? What's your idea?
He was a rich man, and because this, he's traveling by a lot of places.
Around the world.
Around the world.
It's even harder for me. I know.
Around the world.
Around the globe. Okay, that's a good way of getting rid of the word world.
And because of this, Jane getting attention with him.
They were always talking, isn't it? They were always having conversation. Yes. Then he started to share with her.
Yes, and the way of the Thornfield Hall, and a vision of Mrs. Rochester to Jane is because of she's not a rich woman.
Yeah, she's not like self-centered, like thinking of her.
Yes.
So she's kind of.
Care about the way she looks.
Yeah, yeah. She was a simple woman, but she wasn't rich. And I think her personality caught him's attention.
Yes,
because the fact she was really, you know, she had her
it's
own
very
ideas.
Very strong,
you know.
Very strong too. And the ideas of her is very different of the women's of the century.
Mm-hmm. Yes, from this time, because women were more. Tend to not give strong opinions about things. So, and she had strong
opinions.
Okay, we've been talking about Thornfield, her friendship with
Mr. Rochester,
and the fact that Thornfield was a mysterious house. It was a real mysterious house, and many things were happening. Yes, it's frightening fact at during the evening, or at night. Weird things were happening in this house. And we didn't know until we read the story to find out what really happens. It's happening there. What's your input about this? What's your ideas about this?
We know that Thornfield's a really big place. So there's a lot of rooms, and since it's in England, it's a really dark place too, because England is like always dark, always in this rainy weather. And it's always like a dark, like, weather. Always like this air of darkness and mysterious. I believe that being in England, it helped in making the mysterious look of Thornfield even bigger, because it's a dark place. And it has a lot of, like, weird, hidden rooms, which makes it a lot, like, not harder, but a lot difficult to her to understand the place.
Mm-hmm.
Like, she has always been, like, lot smaller places, and now she has, like, a whole mansion with mysteriously different mysterious places that she doesn't know that she's trying to explore. And this thing about the red flag,
the red flag.
That I don't really remember what it was about.
The flag was always shown in a tower. It was a tower, which is like attached to the whole mansion.
Mm-hmm.
If you want to get into the tower, you need need to get out of Thornfield to get into the tower,
mm-hmm.
because it's not really connected to the house. But it was there, you know.
It's a really different kind of thing, and even another mysterious thing that Jane doesn't really her attention is Grace Poole. One of the maids of the house, they describe her as a strange servant at Thornfield, that she spends most of the time at her top of the house and does not say much. We see that she doesn't talk to Jane at all, mm-hmm. almost in the series. She only talks a little bit with Mr. Fairfax, and to a lot about the past of Adele and Mr. Rochester. It's a really mystery to Jane.
Mm-hmm.
That she's trying to figure it out, trying to decipher. And Grace Poole, I think, is the biggest mystery at Jane, because she's always trying to be like nice to her, and she's always like ignoring her. She feels like what's the deal with this woman? Mm-hmm. Why is she so like that? And Jane's exploring part is like achieving in Thornfield. Mm-hmm. I think it's one of the reasons she loves it, because of the mysterious.
Mm-hmm.
I know she loves to read, she loves to draw, and Thornfield has all this mystery that she wrote on her books, and she's living those mysteries, and I think she loves a lot of her because of that.
Mm-hmm. So we have many different aspects in there. So we have the house, we have Mr. Rochester coming and going sometimes, and then suddenly he decides to stay in the house more often than he used to. Jane Eyre gets used to the house. She feels like this is a good place to work and to stay, and that she could start a new life in there. The house is kind of mysterious. There are things happening, like suddenly Mr. Rochester is sleeping, and then he wakes up with Jane Eyre shouting because the bedroom is on fire. So they need to, you know, to put water on it to stop the fire. Sometimes you're sleeping and you see someone trying to open your door, like blah 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 blah, and you don't know who it is.
It's almost like a horror movie to Jane.
Yes, it is. And suddenly he's making a big party with lots of people in the house, and then suddenly you hear a scream in the middle of the night, and then everybody runs out. And what is that? No, it's nothing. It's just your imagination. They think it's a ghost, because there's a story about the ghost in the house.
Yes.
It doesn't happen anything.
We know Jane has a lot of bad things with haunted places because of the Red Room. Mm-hmm. So
and
really gets
we see that Mr. Rochester is bleeding. And now we're just basically about to finish what we have for the first part, which is the fact that Jane Eyre receives a letter. Someone has sent a letter to Jane Eyre. What's really happening? What happened when this letter came up?
The letter say of the aunt of her, Mrs. Reed, and she's sick and she gonna die, and Jane visit her. In this visit, the aunt told of Jane, she has a fortune of her family, and of her parents and the uncle, because she loves her, and
just because now she has this money that she loves her.
Yes.
Yeah. The thing is, she kind of did that just to punish Jane, because she knew that Jane had no relatives. She had no uncle, living uncle. She didn't know that she had. And then suddenly she said, okay, I received this letter 3 years ago, but I never told you because I hated you. She said she did that on purpose. She did that just to hurt Jane Eyre, because she didn't like her. So she received that letter, as you said, and she found out that she has an uncle. She had an uncle.
Miss Reed.
And do you remember what Mrs. Reed did? She sent her uncle a letter back saying she's dead. She died. She was really mean to her. She was really mean. She said, Jane Eyre died. She got a fever and she died. So, and her uncle said, okay, I'm not gonna... I mean, he wanted to take care of Jane. So basically, and do you remember what happened at the end of this chapter? Jane Eyre, that's what I like on Jane Eyre. Because although she did something so bad to Jane, what was Jane's reaction? Do you remember? She forgave her. She said, I forgive you.
She's a really good person.
I forgive you. She is a good person.
She suffered a lot in her life, and she doesn't want anyone to suffer in the same. And I believe she thinks that her, and is really trying to apologize. I believe that she does. And like, she's doing that to me right now, so why should I be remorseful this thing? It happened.
Yeah.
We can't change that. We can only change what's going to happen in the future. And if I keep all this hate in my heart, I'll be as bad as she was.
Yes.
So now I just have to accept whatever she did, forgive her, and follow with my life with Mr. Rochester and adopt the money.
She loves her job. She loves the place where he lives now, Adele, Mr. Fairfax.
Mm-hmm. Mr. Rochester?
Mr. Rochester? Yeah.
Big building.
Yes. So, after that, she gets this new information, and then she goes back to Thornfield. She goes back to Thornfield.
The best
and
place
then,
of the book.
Okay, this is our last part, and it's not going to be with you. It's going to be with Natalia and Luana. Okay, girls, thank you a lot. You've been so nice. I really loved having this time with you, and... It was really special. Thank you very much. I know it's a big challenge for you to speak in English, but let me tell you, I'm really proud of your work and what you've done, okay? Mm-hmm. Thank you a lot.
Okay.
See you next time. I'm gonna invite you more for this kind of stuff. Get ready, okay?
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Bye, everyone.
Bye, guys.
Bye-bye.